Hi guys, today we're going to learn how to use Bootstrap. I got this request from a friend of mine who wanted to know how it works. So already created some stuff here, but I'm gonna go back step by step and I'll take you there. So you go to your browser and you type in Google. After that you type in Bootstrap. Okay, you take that first link of Bootstrap, then you click download, and also click download again, so you find your download in the download folder, which is gonna be there. Let me go to download folder. This is what they call Bootstrap 4. Something. You copy that. You create a folder where you want to run your files. You press it there, then you unzip that, you extract. You see, you get this. So after extraction, you rename this if you want to. You can say this, you can delete that, then you make it to be Bootstrap. So I did that already. So but now I'm gonna delete that folder because I want to use the older folder. Odd folder. So you say move to trash. Also this one, move to trash. Move to trash, and you can see that already I have an HTML file here, which I'm gonna click on and open it. You can see it's blank. There's nothing is going on here, and I'm gonna open it using Notepad, and we see if I can try to do some things here. So as you see here in this folder, we have CSS and JS. You have your JavaScript here, and you also have your cascading style sheet here. So what you're gonna do here, you can see all these files here, and Bootstrap bundle, whatever. You can see all these files, you can read them one by one if you want to. You go back here, you click here. Also you can see the CSS for Bootstrap. So what you're gonna do here, I'll go to Google to get something quicker. I don't want to type much. This is our file. We go to Google again. You can type it how to link Bootstrap to HTML. This. So when you're there, you click here. W3. So now when you do that, I'm gonna check something for you. Try it yourself. Let me do something. I don't need all of that. I needed something simple. You can see all what we can take. We can take these three lines. Okay, after taking those three lines, we have them here. It means we're connecting our Bootstrap, but this Bootstrap is in what is online. So it's pointing on some server somewhere. So what we're gonna do, I can take this to show you the right thing. I don't want to type, guys. I'm a little bit lazy. You paste that, and you paste this and this and this and this. And also, after pasting that, we only needed that. Then you can see the body and stuff like that. So you can go back here. Okay, that's good. So we do body, we close the body, and we say here. We save. After saving, we're gonna test this. We're gonna say H1 say bootstrap. Okay. Whatever I did, I don't know. But I'm gonna show you, this is how to make it. you save your file. After saving your file, there's nothing gonna happen here, but I wanna show you something. Okay, you can see I'm Bootstrap. So now what can you do? Bootstrap use classes. So what you do, you can go to Google and say Google and say Bootstrap H1 classes. Okay, so we're gonna get those classes, and after getting those classes, you can see on their website they show you the classes here: H1, Bootstrap, heading H2, H3, H4, whatever. Okay, so it seems like okay, class H1, class H2, class H3, class H4, whatever. So now the trick is here. You won't see much changes until when we go further. They say class equals to H1. This simply means you're giving this H1 what? An ID which Bootstrap gonna see and give an effect. Look at this. Nothing is changing much, but if we say we talk about button and we say input type equals to, we'll say input type equals to submit, and we come here and say value equals to should be what? Post. Okay, let me look at my button here before we give authority to Bootstrap to change it. Yes, this is my button. So it looks like this before Bootstrap. I guess you can see. So now we wanna try to say class equals to what? Is it default? See, are we gonna get some effect? No. Class equals to button, if I remember. Then success. Then I save and see something here. Nothing's working, but it will work. Google, we're gonna go to Bootstrap. You can see if you want the layout, you get everything here. You see class equals to container if you want to deal with your layout. And okay, let's use this. Let's copy this. We see if we can see the effect here. But I'll do some couple of things so that you become compatible with this. And I'm gonna put inside this my content here, as they say. Okay. After that, I'm gonna save and see if my content is there. Yeah, you can see the you can see that it moved. This moved. It means our Bootstrap is working, but you haven't seen something major here. Content float. Okay. We leave that. What we want to do here? I'm looking for some buttons. It's always good to get things from their website because they are the best people to know what's going on. So I'm looking for buttons. That's when you guys are gonna see how it works. The one I downloaded, I haven't put it I haven't connected it. We're still using the one online. They will talk about navigations and stuff. I don't want us to spend a lot of time here. These are the examples. I think you can also get some templates here. You get their codes and stuff, then paste in your stuff, then you start using it. So what I'm gonna do here, I'm doing just a quick tutorial because a friend of mine asked me something like similar to this, and hope also it helps you. So let's go to Google and say buttons, Bootstrap button classes. Yes, we got that. So you can see, default, primary. Okay, I was supposed to say BTN, not button, in full, I think. Let me try to see. Let me see, submit, I'm gonna say class BTN. BTN. Let me save and see if it's gonna change. Okay. Yeah, you can see. Yes guys, I think everything is fine now. You can see my button changed. So whatever HTML tag you want to change, you go to bootstrap, maybe you say H1 class, H2 classes, maybe button classes. So they're gonna give you all the classes. These are the name of the classes. So mine is success, but if I say primary or default, it's gonna change. I'm gonna use info or warning, then you're gonna see what's going on. I can change the class just to say BTN dash info. Then you save. After saving, you can see that it's changed the color. The color changes, and also there's the one I know which called danger. Danger. If you say danger, then you're gonna have to. Yeah, you can see the button changes. It has a lot of things, Bootstrap. If you want to use it, please do, and it's gonna save you time from typing your code. So you can see all this tutorial, I've been getting codes from Google, and I'll show you how it works. But now we're gonna go back to what brought us here. We're looking for Bootstrap. We want to connect Bootstrap not from the website but from our local server. So what we do, we delete all of this and say Bootstrap. Remember our thing is Bootstrap. We didn't say 3. What we did is like we only okay, let me try to delete this. I want to make it not to work until yes, whatever. I don't think we're gonna need this for now. We might not need this for now, but if you can leave it if you want to. Wanna deal much with CSS on DirectJS. Okay, I'm gonna do this. If I save, you can see if I refresh, nothing changes, everything is go back to normal. So we want to see where we put our Bootstrap and how to reference it. When you go to this HTML folder, okay, you see where our Bootstrap is. So inside there is a folder called CSS, which is this. This is our Bootstrap, but this there's no folder like this. So we delete that folder, and I will remain with that CSS. So that CSS goes and say Bootstrap mini CSS. You click in into that folder. That Bootstrap mini CSS is here. So simply means our Bootstrap now should work. And you save. After saving, I want you to refresh. When you refresh, you see everything's working now. We're refreshing our Bootstrap without going to the website, but it's getting it on your local server. So guys, this is how this is the way to use Bootstrap here. And also it has JavaScript files, how to reference it. This is how to reference. So here you can use your JavaScript, jQuery and stuff like that in here, if you want to do so. Yeah guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget that the first lines we're using, we're referencing Bootstrap online, but now what we downloaded is this, the way you put the whatever way you want to put, but you have to make sure this is the first folder, this is the second folder. So this file is in there already. Whatever file you want to reference, you can do that way. And you can see there are many files here. Whatever files, for maps, for what, for whatever, anything you want to, you reference it that way. So it just depends what you want. Also in your JS, there's everything here you want to use. And guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. And if I made any mistake, guys, please correct me and comment, and also share our content. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video.